WIPO's IGC met June 12th to June 16th here at headquarters in Geneva in its 34th session. Wendland is the committee secretary. Wend, what was on the agenda for the week?
Two things, the first of which was to make progress on the text. This is traditional cultural expressions, or TCEs, or folklore for short. That was the first important item on the agenda. And the second was, this is the end of the mandate of the IGC, the current mandate. And so this session had to take stock of the progress made, think about what would a future mandate look like. It's the assembly in October that will decide on the terms of the mandate.
Any notable outcomes to report then?
Yes, so on those two issues, the IGC did some good work on the TCE text. No one would necessarily say it's a big leap forward, but there's some improvements in the text, and that work was done, so we ticked that box. And the second thing was on the stock taking. Now, this was obviously important, and there the IGC sent a very positive message to the Assembly in agreeing three things, each of them important. The first is that progress has been made in the IGC. Secondly, that the work should go on. And thirdly, asking the Assembly to agree on the terms of the mandate and the program of work.
Anything else you'd like to report?
The session was very well chaired by the IGC chair, Ian Goss from Australia, very well supported by his two vice chairs, Michael Tenne from Indonesia and Yuka Leaders from Finland. They're a very strong team. Two or three other things. The like-minded countries had a very successful, useful roundtable before the session. Secondly, we organized a seminar on the Thursday and Friday before the session. People tell me it was the best ever seminar, and I'd recommend viewers to look at some of the papers, in particular the opening address, the keynote address by Peter Jazzy, and the closing address by Richard Owade. They're on the website. And then finally, the Secretariat met with a high-level Indigenous delegation in the margins of the session. On that occasion, Assistant Director General Minelik Getahun announced a new Indigenous scholarship as of next year, which we're excited about. It's aimed in particular at Indigenous women and youth.
Terrific. Thank you very much, Wend.